You'll probably be banned pretty soon, because you've been doing this film called Farmland, right?
I wouldn't go back to South Africa. So even though I'm not officially banned,
Right.
I've been getting calls from people saying, do not go back to South Africa, whatever you do. But yes, my film Farmlands, it's been a nightmare getting it done in the background. People are like, where is it, Lauren? Where is it? But it will be out this month 100% on the crisis going on in South Africa with the farm murders, the crazy anti-white policies coming from the ANC, and just the overall chaos, drought, and nightmare that South Africa is right now.
Yes. Okay. Well, so you're not going back to South Africa anytime soon, but I don't know that they would
No.
necessarily have you. We'll call that one a wash. For people who don't know what is going on here in South Africa, citizens are taking tactical training themselves. I know you've talked about this, and it's in your film Farmlands. And I appreciate that, by the way. It's going to be. She's not pulling an Anita Sarkeesian. The
Oh,
film should
no.
actually be completed.
Well,
It
that's
ran into
good.
different. You know, see, strong woman over hurdles overcomes them. She jumps over them, like Bruce Jenner before he was Caitlyn.
Used to be known as falling through.
Yes, used to be known as follow through. Now they're arming themselves. They're learning to protect themselves against. This is something that people miss: government-backed marauders. As a Canadian in a country where it's very difficult to obtain firearms, or certainly the Second Amendment is very foreign to them, how did you relate to this, seeing this in South Africa, and did it ring some bells for kind of thinking stateside the Second Amendment and how important it is?
Yeah, so it's actually extremely difficult to get firearms in South Africa as well. When we played the trailer for Farmlands, we had some footage in someone's window and it was showing firearms on the wall. And I was worried because tons of people were like, Lauren, you're trying to exaggerate. Those are just paintball guns on their wall. Those aren't real guns, which is true. Most of the people buy paintball guns so they can stock up with pepper balls and everything for self-defense because they can't get real guns. We met up with a
You
woman
wouldn't know that.
who.
You wouldn't know that seeing the videos with South Africa. But just in general, that'll only piss them off. If
That's
that's
why
a,
Trevor Noah got the hell out.
a government-backed marauder on crack, I don't think a pepper paintball is gonna do it. But sorry, continue.
So people try to defend themselves in all kinds of ways with electric fences, paintball guns, the rest of it. And for the few people that can get guns, which they are desperately trying to get them now, yes, they are practicing self-defense because the government has basically given a free-for-all for the Bantu blacks to take white land, which important thing here for people to understand, the Bantu blacks, which are the tribes that run most of the ANC government, are not indigenous to the land. The Khoisan natives are, and the Khoisan natives are not getting any of the land from white people that is now being redistributed by the
Right.
government. So there's an all-out attack on white people right now for their land. The government has said, go ahead, take it. In fact, we're going to go in and forcefully take it. And the Boer people are training with whatever they can get. If they can get guns, they're using that. If they can get paintballs, most of it is just for self-defense
Go
purposes.
back there and tell them not to use the paintballs. I would tell them you'd be better off just sharpening pointy sticks than paintballs. They'd be better off trying to find an Acme anvil that they could hit a button and drop on somebody. That's a more realistic expectation than fighting these people off with paintballs.
Work for Rwanda.
That's actually a really good point. There's this one girl who I met with, and this will be in the documentary. She runs one of those paintball studios who sells stuff to the Boer people and to people who just actually want to go paintballing. Every
Don't use the pepper.
she actually has a time in her head. She's like, on Thursdays at about 4 p.m., people come in and break in with guns. She's been beaten with a pipe a couple times, had to go for serious psychological, just kind of.
That'd be legitimate
She, she,
PTSD. Not, you know, not a
she.
feminist had a conservative show up at their conference like yours truly. Legitimate PTSD. You hit
Exactly.
with a lead pipe, we'll give you that one.
Exactly. She has serious PTSD, but she talks about it so nonchalantly. She's like, yeah, at about 4 p.m. on these days, they come in and rob me. Right after we interviewed her, 2 days later, she had another armed robbery occur, and she's now moving out of the country, sold her paintball shop. But there you go. Can't do much defending yourself with paintball guns against literally having your place broken into every single day.